Unscripted.
You know, I think it's funny. For the most part, I pretty much stay out of like the tech conversations and stuff like that. While I am getting better when it comes to the technology behind these consoles and, you know, actively try to learn about them things. Obviously, there's some things where I can be like, hey, that's a cool thing. And then I have to kind of look it up myself to see what it even means. The main thing that I've noticed when it comes to game consoles or when it comes to any kind of technology is, you know, you pretty much have to try it for yourself and know what's going on. And I can remember last generation when the Xbox One came out and I was big time pro Xbox. Again, reason why I'm pro Xbox at that particular point was they had lots of exclusive games. It looked like they were investing heavily into games. I know that there was some negative points around Xbox, around some of their ideas, but all those ideas were scrapped before the thing even launched. So I didn't understand a lot of the uproar, especially when I saw stuff like Sunset Overdrive and Quantum Break and, you know, Titanfall, and, you know, these games all looked really good to me. And so I couldn't really understand why people were still pissed off. And now we have this kind of situation where, you know, technology keeps on changing around us and everybody wants to act like they know what technology is and everybody's making videos and everybody's, you know, doing this and everybody's doing that. The funny thing back then was, I can remember distinctly, and you guys probably, some of you probably remember this story, was that, you know, I can remember when Shadow of War came out, or Shadow of Mordor, one of the first one that came out, and Digital Foundry didn't do a test to see the actual frame or the resolution on that. And that game came out for the whole weekend. All people did was speculate about the resolution. Turns out, you know, everybody was like, that's definitely 720p on Xbox One. Well, it's 1080p on the PS4. Whoa, man, that's great. You know, it's really crappy looking and blurry on Xbox One. I mean, then at the end of the, you know, the next week, Digital Foundry said, well, it was 900p on Xbox. Like, nobody knew. Like, that's the point. It's so funny to see so many people be, like, quote-unquote experts on this stuff when, realistically, nobody knows this stuff, you know? Like, nobody really knows. And I think that that's sort of the case we're going to get into with this video. Probably saw the title and you're like, oh, here we go again. Crap, gamers are flip-flopping. No, this isn't about that. This is really something else. I just kind of wanted to have a little fun with it. So that's what this channel is all about, having fun. And I have fun with stuff. So, you know, hopefully you guys understand that. But we're going to get into this right now. What's up, everybody? Crap Gamer here with Crap Gamer Reviews, back with another video. Thank you very much for checking it out. I appreciate it. Please like, share, subscribe. I would appreciate that as well. It helps out the channel and it means a lot to me personally. If you're looking for a way to help out the channel, like my little crappy channel, the best way to do it is a simple like. It helps out a lot and it means a lot to me personally. And, you know, like I said, it just really does mean a lot if you guys would come check it out and like the video. That's what any content creator would ask for. Shout out to all the old subscribers, new subscribers, and everybody in between. You are amazing. Thank you so much for always rocking out with me and just being so awesome. It really does just mean the world to me. Thank you guys very much. So, you know, with that being said, I kind of wanted to cover some of the stuff that was said. Maybe you guys know about this on the weekend. Probably some of you guys, to be honest, don't know what it is that I'm going to be talking about. So I'm going to do my best to kind of describe this. And, you know, hopefully you guys can kind of follow with me. It's not terribly difficult to think about, but it is very definitely something that people should probably take into consideration. So we have the first PS5 die shot posted online, and it has the console's SoC or SoC. The very first die shot was posted online by a Twitter user who specializes in taking close-up, including infrared shots of high-end chipsets. One thing that's abundantly clear from the PS5 die shot is how caches are separated, which means that PlayStation 5 features no Infinity Cache, despite speculations of contrary. AMD introduced Infinity Cache on its RDNA 2-powered Radeon RX 6000 GPUs. It's an all-new cache level of 128 megabytes, whose purpose is to enable high bandwidth power or performance at low power and low latency, acting as a bandwidth multiplier. So this was something that I think a few tech people had speculated and suggested, that the PlayStation 5 have an Infinity Cache. By the way, this was part of the reason that people were saying that maybe the PlayStation 5 had above RDNA 2. But the thing is, to be honest with you, the Xbox Series X doesn't have an Infinity Cache either. So people that say that that's full RDNA 2, that's kind of a misnomer too. That's not exactly accurate. So what we see here is that it's not exactly the same case. So basically, what this means is, I mean, there's a few different things, honestly, that it means. But the PS5 APU breakdown reveals that some Zen 2 feature parts are actually missing from the console, with another user noting that there is no unified cache, obviously that's what I was talking about, or Infinity Cache for the GPU. This probably won't mean much unless you're in big tech, but people are already commenting that the PS5 isn't as powerful as people initially assumed. This is really something that I guess would really take people. It would depend on the type of person that you are. But one of the comments was, it looks like some Zen 2 FPU parts are missing. A first quick and dirty die shot of the PS5 APU. It looks like some parts are missing for sure. And people say the lack of FPU extensions for Zen 2 are logical, as AVX2 will kill performance, heat frequency, and should not be on the CPU. Obviously, there's a lot of other things going into play here. There's also a lot of talk about VRS. People were saying originally that the PS5 didn't have VRS. Now it's gone from the PS5 doesn't have VRS to it's not hardware VRS, but software VRS. And, it just sounds like we're getting to this whole thing over and over again. Now, the thing that I want to talk about is, for me personally, I think that it's a little bit redundant and a little bit ridiculous. For you see, mostly like a lot of Xbox fans and fanboys try to send me this and say stuff like, well, let's talk about this. How come you aren't talking about this? Which, again, by the way, I kind of talk about stuff at my own particular time and my own particular time frame. But when it comes down to it, in this high technology stuff, I don't, people are like, well, you got to take the L now, right? I'm like, listen, I don't remember really championing Infinity Cache or anything like that. If I did, then certainly I would be like, okay, that's my bad for, going with this rumor or whatever. But I can't even honestly remember talking about it because it's not something that's my forte, right? Like, I'm not that person that talks about, this kind of stuff. Because again, like I said, it's not exactly something that I know, a lot of stuff about. So I will usually try to keep quiet about something like that. I think some people tried to bring it up and I'm like, it just, I don't know. So, obviously there were some, quote unquote, trusted people talking about this. And, I understand that, I just think that, when it comes to like a little bit slower times in the news and stuff like that, we all kind of get this kind of situation where stuff like this can happen. And again, things change, so we don't really know. It's odd that this thing's already been out on the market all these months and we're just now kind of finding out about it. It can take some people by surprise, and I really do understand how people feel. But to the Xbox fanboys that are bragging about this, right, like as if it's some kind of huge deal, the thing that I brought up myself that I don't understand is, how are Xbox fans bragging about this being like a bad thing for PlayStation when PlayStation 5 is literally kicking the crap out of the Xbox Series X in almost every new game performance wise, right? Why is it doing that if it's such a bad, I just think that obviously there's going to be some cost cutting on both of these things because you have a $400 console, the PS5, out there, still out there doing the things that it's able to do. And you look at stuff like the ray tracing that it's able to pull off with Spider-Man and things like that, and you can just really see that they did a really good job with it. I mean, this console is capable of doing 4K, capable of doing up to 120 frames per second, capable of doing ray tracing, capable of doing all this stuff on a $399 price tag when the controller itself is like a $79 controller or whatever it is, right? So realistically, it's just like you're really getting your money's worth when you buy this thing, and obviously there's going to be some concessions, but for people to be disappointed or trying to use this as a point to kind of poke fun at the PlayStation 5 when it's really been doing a huge job of kind of taking care of the Xbox Series X and doing better on a lot of games in the Xbox Series X. And now when I say that, I'm not talking about like some of the older games. I realize that the Xbox Series X is probably a little bit better suited for like the old games and stuff like that, and utilizing the Xbox One X, which was a much more powerful machine than the Pro. You know, I just feel like at the end of the day, what's going on is, you know, I think that we're going to keep seeing some things like this happen. You know what I mean? Where people, you know, it's kind of an interesting situation. And, you know, people expect me to go, oh man, now all of a sudden I hate PlayStation 5, or, you know, they sucked, or they whatever. Listen, like I said, when I was playing those Xbox One games years and years ago and enjoying myself, I couldn't tell the resolution. You know, I'm playing the PS5. It has the most impressive stuff I've ever seen. You can go back and play the base PS4 exclusives, like, you know, Uncharted 4, Horizon Zero Dawn, God of War, Spider-Man, and those games look better than stuff on a 6 teraflop Xbox One X. Those exclusives, okay? There's a reason behind it. You know, and I'm sure that Sony's developers are going to take full advantage of it. I'm sure that third-party developers are going to take a full advantage of it. There's absolutely no doubt in my mind as to what's happening here. And, you know, I just thought it was funny that everybody expects you to go, oh, you know, I'm just going to abandon ship or whatever. And, you know, that's something that really kind of just blows my mind. But, you know, at the end of the day, I'm going to link this. Let me know what you guys think. Are you guys on board with PlayStation 5? Do you guys not care about this stuff? Are you on my camp when it comes to this? I would love to know. Let me know what you guys think. Sound off, rate, comment, subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic day. Rack 'em up. Game on, my friends. Game on. Crap Gamer out. Unscripted.